Have you ever wanted to misbehave?
I'm sorry.
Have you ever felt patronized?
They are my hotel guests, and I treat them as such.
Have you ever been tempted?
Like football, temptation is coming home. It's a thrill to be tantalized.
And you feel right at home with me, Bob Mills, in Not a Lot of People Know That. With animated comic entertainment like that, Monday night will fly by. From 9:30 on BBC One.
When you meet a new couple...
Hello, gorgeous.
Hello, gorgeous.
Do you find yourself wanting to ask them personal questions? What do you look for in a man?
Teeth.
Wanting to snoop around their home?
Very pastel, very boring shirts. Even the compact discs are catalogued alphabetically.
Maybe even see them snog someone else.
I think you need another shilling in your meter.
Well, the Guess the Partners game is back. The Other Half, tomorrow at 6:20 on BBC One.
And this is BBC One.
They're as friendly and as affectionate as any pet.
Very squealy. They're quite cute.
Not quite as bad as tarantulas, but close.
Animal lovers.
We're both going to get our makeover done at the same time.
Treat other creatures as equals.
I really, really love the new rabbit.
The new series of Vets in Practice starts Tuesday at 8 on BBC One.
Poll to Poll with Michael Palin in 5 minutes after a summary of the news, now on BBC One with Jenny Bond.
Good morning. The Prime Minister is visiting Scotland in what's being seen as an attempt to give Labour a boost following a big rise in support for the Scottish National Party. He's also expected to announce plans to extend the government's New Deal programme to people who want to become self-employed.
Living through an economic miracle...
Tony Blair was last in Scotland in March for his party's annual conference in Perth. His absence since then has led some commentators to suggest the Prime Minister's uneasy with his Scottish party. The persistence of local government sleaze allegations, rows about how the party's selected its candidates for the new Edinburgh Parliament, and a worrying downward trend in the polls, all have made Scotland difficult territory for the Prime Minister.
Although the stated aim of Tony Blair's visit here in Dundee is the New Deal for the self-employed, a more important objective is to bolster his Scottish party's fortunes. They'll need all the help they can get to fight off the nationalist challenge ahead of next May's first elections to the Edinburgh Parliament.
The jury in the case of the childminder accused of murdering a 5-month-old baby in her care is expected to retire today to consider its verdict. The prosecution claims Helen Stacey shook Joseph Mackin to death in a fit of temper. The court heard that the baby was a classic victim of shaken baby syndrome. Helen Stacey denies murder. The remains of Russia's last Tsar, Nicholas II, and his family have been buried in St. Petersburg. The service took place 80 years to the day after they were killed by Bolshevik revolutionaries.
President Yeltsin flew into the former imperial capital from Moscow for the burial of the last Tsar. He was greeted by, among dignitaries distantly related to Nicholas II, Prince Michael of Kent. The remains of the Tsar, Empress Alexandra, and several of their children and attendants were laid in the Peter and Paul Cathedral, surrounded by the graves of their Romanov forebears. Mr. Yeltsin bowed his head before their coffins. He called for repentance for their murder at the end of a century marked by blood and lawlessness. Then Tsar Nicholas II's small oak coffin was lowered into its final resting place, 80 years after his assassination by Bolshevik revolutionaries, closing the chapters many Russians hope on one of the most tragic